Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we're going to do some Spice Girl nails. Guess who my favourite Spice Girl is?
Baby Spice.
No.
But that's why I thought you Ginger. Had the
gypsies. Yes, Ginger Spice. So we're going to do all the Spice Girls on here, inspired by them, things that they wear, their like funky attitudes and all that. So I've already prepped Cheryl's nails. As you can see, Cheryl's natural smile line is higher this side than it is that side. So I'm just going to trim this area here and make it match her natural smile line. I'm going to leave the thumb till last. I'm going to sculpt all of these out. And we've got some, look, Ultra Bond acid primer. And nail prep dehydrator. Look at them. Look at the new packaging. I love it. So we're going to dehydrate first. I've got acid prime. I'm going to use medium speed. I'm going to pick up a big bead. So I've got a size 12 round brush. So I can pick up a big, massive bead because we are going to do long nails. So I'm working from the free edge. Let's tip this down so it'll start to run down. Number four. Starting at the free edge first of all, because this will set a little bit slower. Even though we're doing it first, it's got no warmth from the skin. So there's no warmth from that finger that's gonna help it to set quicker. We want it to all set at a very similar time.
Did you go and watch the Spice Girl movie at the pictures?
Yeah. You don't know who Cheryl is? Oh, you need to look her up. Cheryl Walker Nail Design. Check her out. Top gel tech. And I'll just put your trumpet back in that case. So I'm going to file them all now, do my normal filing routine. It's a very long nail, so you see how I've got my fingers over that length to support that nail. I don't want it to cause too much stress onto Cheryl's nails. Once I've done those side walls, I will do the cuticle area. I'm going to go in the cuticle area with a slightly softer file. So we've just gone from an 80 grit to a 120 grit. The lower the number, the more coarse the file. So if you look at a 240 grit file, this is a lot softer. So we use this on the natural nail. I'm going to make that nice and flush. Free edge. Tiny bit off this side, because as I'm looking down the barrel it was slightly lower, and then we can contour the surface. Give it a buff. I'm going to do this on all of the nails. Once I've filed them, we can build the artwork. I'm going to start with Scary Spice. I'm going to do Scary Spice on this little one. And we're going to do Leopard Print, obviously, because she was a lover of Leopard Print. Well, I actually love Leopard Print as well. We're going to do it a little bit different than we've done before in previous videos, just to change it up a bit for you. I'm going to use Butterscotch as the base, and we're also going to use Steampunk from the Cat's Eye range, and we're going to use Serious Black. Because this nail is so long, I'm going to start at the bottom, and I'm going to go up to top, get that nice and close to the cuticle, and then as I drag down, I'll touch the other gel polish and it'll drag through nice and neatly. Second coat of colour, we're going to do the same. Pop me that in the lamp. We're going to use some backing paper from a sculpting foam to put a little bit of the steampunk gel polish on. I'm just going to dot this around. You don't need to do perfect circles. And I'm going to do the ones at the top first. So the ones in this section first. Then I'm going to take the wand, the cat's eye wand, and just pull some of that pigment so you get a nice little effect. Now I'm going to do this in two different halves because it's so curved down here. I won't get the magnet all the way over, so I'm going to come down this side. And we're going to do this side. I'm going to use Serious Black. So this is for the little black bits that sort of go around the outside. You don't want to join them up really. You want them to go like that, so they go big to little. So once I've gone round all of those little marks, I will then add some little tiny little black little marks like this, just to add a little bit more detail. So I'm going to top coat that one now. Going to move on to Sporty Spice. Sporty Spice obviously wears loads of sporty stuff. She was always seen in a lot of Adidas stuff, so or Adidas, however you want to say it. Do the Americans say Adidas?
I don't know. I think it's a mixture. I know people who mixture. Say Adidas.
I say Adidas.
I say Adidas.
Yeah, I say Adidas. Do you say Adidas?
Adidas.
Adidas. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know what the correct pronunciation of it is.
I don't know.
For the background colour, we're going to do black and white on this nail. I am going to use a metallic black because, do you know, back in the day when Spice Girls were all like the big thing, it was all about satin.
Oh yeah.
Wanted satin tracksuits.
Just after the shell suits.
So you'd have the shell suits.
Yeah.
And then you've got satin ones.
Mm-hmm.
That satin finish. So I want to do that satin finish as well. So that's what we're going to do. The metallic black. Because it'll, you know, give it that kind of look. Because we're going to use a metallic black, I'm going to top coat. The metallic range needs to sit over the top of a shiny surface. If it doesn't go on a shiny surface, it will go quite matte. Pop me that in the lamp. So because I'm going to put white at the top here, I'm only going to go up to about there. Because I'm going to do stripes on the black, I'm going to do the Adidas stripes. And then the top section will be white with the black logo. Right, now I'm going to top coat it. I'm only going to top coat that section. It needs to be top coated before you do anything else over the top of it. Now we're going to use Snow White. Get it nice and crisp at the cuticle. going to create a line. Don't worry about it being too perfect at this point. And we'll do two coats of that, but we're not going to cure yet. We're going to clean that line up. So I'm dipping in my gel residue wipe off solution, wiping off the excess, and then I'm just going to pull that across. Pop me that in the lamp. So I'm going to take some of the, I was going to say mega white, it's not mega white, it's snow white. And we've got the striping brush, which is 03. You need to prep that brush by running it through. Don't think you can just put it on and go straight away. You want to make sure that it's going through all the bristles of the brush. And what you can do on here is have a little test of pulling your lines so you can see how much pressure you'll need. Can you see that, Adam? I know it's hard when it's white on white. Oh, it's not too bad. Oh. So we'll go for that a little. Okay, first one's going to be pulled down the centre. One more pull, and what you'll find is, because we're working on the top coat, it will shrink back slightly and it'll go slightly thinner. Wait for it to shrink back a little bit and it'll actually go thinner and a little bit neater. So now I've got all three lines on, I'm just gonna do a thin layer over the top, just to make them even more white, and you can at this stage neaten anything up you need to neaten. I'm just going to take the sticky layer off that because I want to just buff this. Because I'm going to use Serious Black to do the logo, and I really want it to stick, so it's just going to smooth everything a little bit as well. Right, I'm going to top coat it now. Right, we're going to move on to Baby Spice. Let's get rid of those and bring in some gorgeous pink colours. So for Baby Spice, we're going to use all pinks, and I've chose that because she wore a lot of pink and she's a baby girl. She's my baby girl. We're going to do an angled scallop shape going up the nail. So the first one will be dead simple. Just paint that on, and then all I'm going to do is drag this back. Like that. Then cure. And we use dragon fruit for that one. It is a beautiful colour. Next colour is baby cakes. I just don't know. Right, so same again. I've just blended that up. Don't worry about, oh for God's sake, it's a big bit of fluff. We will worry about that. Don't worry about this being perfectly blended. All it is so we can overlap the colour. So we've done a straight-ish line. So what we're going to do is create a wavy scallop edge. So you're going to go in to the gel that you've just put on, drag it out to create a scallop edge. Because she wore stuff that was very frilly, really girly. So we want this to be really girly. The next colour will be Quick Kiss. So you can see we are going lighter and lighter the further we go up.
Do you like that one? Strawberry cream.
What's your favourite Spice Girl song, Cheryl?
To Become One.
Yeah. I remember singing that in an audition.
For what?
It wasn't for being a band. So I'm just going to top coat this now and seal it all in. Make it nice and shiny. Pop me that in the lamp. Now for ginger spice, my favourite of all the Spice Girls. So we're obviously going to do a Union Jack because she wore that Union Jack dress. And guess what, Cheryl? Guess what, Adam?
What?
I had one of them dresses.
Do we have any pictures of you in said dress?
I hope we don't have any pictures of me in said dress. So we're going to use Snow White, Ocean Ridge, and for the red we're actually going to use the red metallic just to change it up a bit, just so it's not like a normal Union Jack. It's got a little bit of something else. You can use just a red gel polish. I like candy apple, so if you haven't got the metallics, you could use candy apple. We're going to start with a white background. I am not doing a proper Union Jack, and I say proper, I mean a full Union Jack. We're just going to do like a section. Right, so I'm going to start with these two pieces because that's going to make my center. I'm going to know where that red's going to go. The red's going to fall into there, so we need to go about there. So I do the edges first, then I fill in. Then we're going to mirror that. Thank you. What's your favourite Spice Girl song?
I don't know any.
Oh, come on now.
What?
Adam, you're letting us down.
I don't really know. Like, I can't remember any.
You're not into them then?
Well, I remember back in like 1995 or 94, something like that. That was when they were big, wasn't it? 94, 95. And I knew some of the songs, but I can't remember them.
Mm.
That's more than 20 years ago.
Oh my God, yeah. Right, so we're going to use a striping brush that we used earlier into the red metallic dragon's blood. Now it's all set or dry, we're going to top coat. Right, now posh. Because posh is quite sophisticated.
We'll just do black then.
We're going to do just sophisticated now. We're going to do black with bling. I'm going to top coat. I nearly made a mistake and I want to do the bottom bit first. You can start from the top, I just, when it's so long, it's a bit easier to get that bottom in first and then you can just drag through top to bottom.
It's easier to cap, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Right, we're going to put bling on. So what we're going to do, we're going to top coat this again, but I'm going to buff it first. So we're going to back to scary, give her a bit of a buff. Just going to wipe over that. I love that. Oh, I like it. Do you like it matte? Oh, I think we're just going to top coat that and make it matte. I'm going to buff it matte like that. Top coat it just so it's a bit smoother, yeah? Award-winning nail tech sat here in front of me. Pop that in the lamp. Now that's top coated, I'm going to top... I'm not going to top coat it. Now it's top coated, I'm going to buff it to make it really matte. I really like that finish. You could use your matte top coat, but I do want to smooth this a little bit more as well. So I think we're sort of doing two things at once here. We're matting out that nail and we're also making it nice and smooth. You need a soft buffer. Don't go in with a file or anything like that because it'll just eat into the nail and it ruin your design, and we don't want to do that. I'm going to buff this as well because I feel like it's a bit lumpy bumpy because obviously the gel upon gel, you get that little edge where we've done that scallop frilly kind of shape.
That was the design.
No, well, I want it a bit smoothy. I'm also going to buff this one.
Okay.
Because of the wonderful things he does. So what we're going to do is we're going to use the aqua gel to put the stones on with. So I'm going to squeeze. Well, I'm going to do a bit of a cluster. And what we're going to do is we're going to try and hide. We'll hide the chewed cuticle.
Behind loads of bling.
Yeah. If in doubt, add a bit of bling. Right, we're going to finish them all with some cuticle oil. Anyway, I'll get some Spice Girl inspired nails for the gorgeous Cheryl. I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe, and everything I've used today will be listed below. Bye bye. So you see, when Faye tells me what to do, you know, she's not actually an LTEC. But when Cheryl advises me, as she has through this video, I take it on board because she knows her stuff. Whereas Faye's just bossy.
And what, I'm not always right?
Definitely not always right.
Because the customer's not always right.
Are they, heck?
No.
They think they are.
They think they are.